Over in Ormoc City, Mayor Lucy Torres Gomez also seeking another term. Sharon Avita now joins us with that story. Sharon, over to you.
Yes, Carmina. Ormoc City Mayor Lucy Torres Gomez has officially filed her certificate of candidacy for the upcoming 2025 elections on the second day of the COC filing. She is running again to continue her service to the people of Ormoc. Mayor Lucy was accompanied by her husband, 4th District of later Representative Richard Gomez. Also joining her were some local officials, her mother and her daughter, Juliana. If re-elected, this will be her second term as mayor of Ormoc City. She first assumed the role in 2022 after an interesting political exchange with her husband, Richard Gomez. Prior to Lucy's term as mayor, Richard won as Ormoc City mayor from 2016 to 2022. The couple effectively swapped position in 2022, with Richard running for and winning as representative of latest 4th District, a position previously held by Lucy. The couple are well-known personalities from the entertainment industry before entering politics. Sharon Avita, ABS-CBN.
Thanks a lot. Sharon Avita there joining us on the line. Supporters of the candidates filing their COCs again gathered outside the Manila Hotel. Paige Javier is there to give us an update. Paige?
Carmina, a sea of red filled the Quirino Grandstand this morning on the second day of COC filing for the 2025 national and local elections. Supporters of incumbent Senator Aimee Marcos and the United Senior Citizens Party list supported their bets. Now, some of them said they arrived as early as 6 in the morning or 2 hours before the start of COC filing. It was an all-out fiesta for Senator Marcos, with dozens of her supporters, including a band, dancers, and members of an indigenous group. Marcos arrived past 8:40 in the morning, joining her supporters at the Quirino Grandstand before heading to the filing venue. Another group in red are supporters of the United Senior Citizens Party list. They also brought drums and tarpaulins as they walked from the Quirino Grandstand to the Manila Hotel Tent City to send off their aspirants. Now, Carmina, all of these gimmicks are still allowed since there is no ban on premature campaigning. But the COMELEC and the police appeal to the aspirants and their supporters to avoid disrupting traffic and the general public. Compared to yesterday, we're seeing more police presence here to ensure peace and order in the area. Right in front of the entrance of the Manila Hotel, there are police stationed to make sure that there are no crowds of supporters to gather there. Police said now if these supporters reach the area where we're standing now, they will speak with these supporters and kindly ask them to disperse or move their program back to the Quirino Grandstand. Now, earlier I mentioned that it was a fiesta-like mood or atmosphere for Senator Marcos. It was the complete opposite for re-electionist Senator Lito Lapid and former Senators Tito Soto and Panfilo Lacson. We went around the area to see if they had supporters here who wanted to show these aspirants that they were here backing their bid for a Senate seat. However, we did not see any supporters of the said aspirants here outside the Manila Hotel. So for them, it was a quiet day of COC filing. That's the situation here outside Manila Hotel. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Paige Javier, there joining us live. Senator Juan Miguel Zubiri urging courts to speed up the resolution of other hazing-related cases. He made that appeal as he welcomed the conviction of Fratman in Atio Castillo's death. Zubiri, who authored the law that tightened penalties against hazing, believes a guilty verdict is the best deterrence to the crime.
It's convictions that we need here. Ito mga pending this last 5 years or so, ilabas na ng korte itong mga kasong ito. Huwag po sana sila mapadelay or they'll continue in the delaying tactics that are being done by the defense, and just come up with a conviction such as this.
Similarly, Zubiri urged leaders of the Tau Gamma Phi, the fraternity said to be behind the death of 11th grader Ren Joseph Bayan, to finally put an end to what he called a culture of violence. Justice Secretary Crispin Remulla is in Timor-Leste, where he met with President Jose Ramos Horta. Adrian Ayala now joins us to tell us what the two officials discussed. Adrian.
Hi, Carmina. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla went to DD Timor-Leste to ask for the continued cooperation of its government in the extradition of former Negros Oriental Representative Arnulfo Teves Jr. In a statement, the DOJ said Remulla recently concluded a state visit to Timor-Leste and met with President Jose Ramos Horta yesterday, October 1. Teves is undergoing extradition hearings before the Timor-Leste Court of Appeals so he can face his multiple murder charges here in the Philippines in connection with the death of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo and 9 others. Remulla also relayed to Horta the challenges posed by the possible entry of gambling in the predominantly Catholic country, as Philippine offshore gaming operators or POGOs are reportedly eyeing Timor-Leste. The DOJ issued a statement following an official statement from Attorney Ferdinand Topacio, lawyer for Teves, asking Remulla about a supposed round-trip flight chartered by the Philippine government from Davao to Timor-Leste and if public funds were used. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Adrian Ayalin there joining us on the line.